Hi there, Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today we're going to do this loose watercolor painting of some roses, and I am just flicking some water onto this. It's roughly 5x7 piece of handmade watercolor paper, and I'm using some crimson red here with about a number 6 round synthetic brush, and I am just loosely sketching in the center of a tightly packed rose. So kind of think of this kind of like you're sketching. Now, I am recording the voiceover for this after the fact because when I went to play and create, I was feeling kind of in a rut, and I did turn the camera on in case something great happened, but I really, I kind of felt like I had lost my mojo, but I was so happy with the way this painting came out. It was my favorite out of all the ones that I did today, and I thought I had a lot maybe to add after the fact in a voiceover, because sometimes it's tough to talk when you're trying to use a different type of paper and kind of do something a little differently than what you usually do. So I've grabbed some yellow, and I'm continuing on this loose, sketchy rose picture, and I'm kind of fleshing out some different elements. Like right here, I'm putting in a little flower bud that's starting to open, and I'm just kind of seeing where my paint bleeds, because remember, I splashed some paint on at the beginning, so I'm getting some interesting shapes that I'm turning into flowers kind of as I go along. So I'm painting slow, I'm taking my time, and I'm just really enjoying the process. I decided not to speed this up because most of you guys say you prefer them not to be sped up, but there is a little gear at the bottom of the YouTube player if you do want to make it faster. I grabbed a little sap green, and I'm just kind of sketching in some tiny little petals around the little rosebud there. They tend to have like tiny little kind of skinny petals right around like the hip of the rose, and then they're bigger and more almond shaped as like they're off the lower parts of the branches. So I'm putting in some of these more almond shaped petals around the big flower. I'm dripping in a little bit of turquoise, and the paints that I'm using, this is interesting, they are actually student grade Yarka tube paints that I bought like probably 20 years ago, and I just wanted to have fun today, so I'm like, I'm gonna use weird paper that I've never used before. I'm gonna use cheap paint, and I'm just gonna have fun with it. So if I can find all the resources that I'm using, I'll put them in the video description, but please use what you have and have fun and play, and I think that's the best way to get to know supplies that you might not be familiar with. So here I'm just pretty much using just watery, like a dirty watery brush, to just trace in the shapes of a couple more rose leaves, and then I'm just dripping in some sap green, and this is a really vivid sap green. It's almost like a bamboo green or something. It's super, super vivid. So I needed to darken it, and I just think this turquoise is a good color. You could use a phthalo blue or Prussian blue. In fact, I'm not exactly 100% sure what the pigments are in this one because they weren't listed on the tubes. And the paint was so old that actually it had hardened in the tubes, so I had to cut the tubes off of them and just kind of like drop them into a palette. Actually, I put them in an ice cube tray, and I immediately regretted it because it was so bulky in my storage. So I actually scraped them out of there and put them in my Turner watercolor palette, because I pretty much used up all of those colors. And I really wanted these Yarka ones to be kind of out for kind of play use, because man, they are really good quality. I don't know why they call them student grade, honestly. I did do a little swatch of them. Sorry about this tangent, guys. I did do a swatch of them last summer, and I taped them to the east facing window in my garage so that it would get like direct sunlight, and they did not fade a scrap because I cut the swatch in half and put it downstairs in a closed binder, and there was no difference at the end of the summer. So that was 3 months of direct sunlight. So I really like these. I hope I can find them for you guys to link them up, because they are just fantastic and very, very cheap paint. So you gotta love that. So again, I've got that other little flower there that was just kind of some, you know, bleedy paint happiness happening. And I'm just adding some petals. No, this is funny, because actually after I did this one, I'm like, oh, this is so cool, I'm gonna do another one, a different flower, and I'm gonna live narrate it. And not that I sound completely composed doing a voiceover, but it was a hot mess. That's all I can say. It was such a hot mess. I'm adding a little bit of a lemon yellow in there just to kind of bring some more highlight to the leaves. Basically, the leaves are sap green, some lemon yellow, and also some of that turquoise color. You could probably just skip the sap green, honestly, because you can mix it with what you have there. I didn't add any like browns or any neutrals to this because I have that nice strong crimson color and I have the greens. I can easily neutralize those to make grays and browns later on when I wanted to do the stems. So just kind of keep that in mind. You don't have to add neutrals. Of course, using these colors to mix a brown, I would end up with more of a transparent, less textural brown, whereas if I used burnt sienna, I would have a more earthy, granular brown. So, I mean, it just depends on what you want, really. Again, doing that same little sketch idea, I start with a tighter area of the flower, put in those little kind of tightly, like, lines for the petals, just tightly close together lines. And then when it hits a wet area, it blooms out to a bigger petal, and it just is kind of like a happy accident. I just encourage you to play. This paper does make it very, very easy to get those kind of fun, happy accidents. It's an extremely rough paper. Like I said, this is I don't know if I told you. It's actually, well, I'm going to say it now. It's a Shazan. Sounds like a magic trick. Shazan. I don't know if that's how you pronounce it, but Shazan Indian watercolor paper, and it's an awful lot like the Nujabi watercolor paper, which I think is also made in India. This Shazan paper is 100% recycled, 100% rag, acid-free, but I just love the fact that it's recycled. I don't know if they're recycling it from like cotton clothing or if it's from recycled from cotton paper. Is that 100% rag? But it's internally and externally sized, so I'm not having a tremendous feathering issue with this. It's rough, so you're not going to get a super crisp line, but I don't feel like it's an unsized paper, you know, like working on a rice paper or something. I feel like I'm able to let the colors float. You won't get blooms on this paper. I did totally, like, do a super juicy painting, and I got no blooms, and there are puddles sitting on that. So that's something to keep in mind. If you do not like the look of blooms, I would encourage you to give this a try. But if you do try it, please get rid of any preconceived idea of what your watercolor is supposed to look like and just go with the flow and have fun. And I was just feeling in a mood where I just wanted to play, and I feel like this is such a wonderful paper for that. So I was just excited to find it. I found it at a local, well, not really that local. We were taking a little day trip down to Belfast, and I found it in a little shop. And actually, I saw a big package of it, and I was like, oh, I want to try this, but I don't want to buy a big package of 100 sheets because if I don't like it, then I'm stuck with this paper. And the lady said, we have single sheets of this. So I was like totally psyched because instead of buying a package of small sheets, I was able to get one large sheet that I could tear down and do a lot of fun stuff with. So there, I did make that neutral for the stem there, and I was signing my name because I was thinking that I was done. But then as I was kind of looking, I was like, oh, there's that corner there, not much happening there. So maybe I'll splash on some water. Maybe I'll splash on a little color and get some interesting background stuff happening there. And that's what I did. And I was really happy with the way it turned out. At first, I was a little concerned that I had too vivid of paint there. But you know what you can do? If you ever are doing the spattering technique and it's like, whoa, I regret this, blot it. And honestly, you're going to get a soft look. It's going to be just right. So please don't freak out if you splatter it and then change your mind. That's pretty much it. I mean, you can fuss around a little bit more. You can, you know, deepen up some of the folds. Like I did let this dry. And I came back and I decided, well, maybe I'll redefine a few of these tightly packed petals, especially where the color had kind of smooshed together. Smoosh, that's a technical watercolor term, guys. And just kind of sharpen things up a little bit. But again, if you like the softer look, leave it soft. It's completely up to you. I'd love to know what you think in the comments below. What do you think of this paper? I'm really having fun with it. It's definitely not for like a highly realistic botanical look, but for doing something fun and loose, it is so much fun. And even if you are someone who prefers to do realism, it's a fun exercise, and trying something different never hurts. I don't think it's you either succeed or you learn. So what's wrong with that? So I'm just putting a few little finishing touches on this. This is pretty much all I'm going to do to it. I want to thank you so much for spending some of your day with me. Please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. And until next time, happy crafting!